Hello guys, I'm Johnny and today we are going to configure our local and production environment. First of all, before diving into some code, let's explain a little bit what is the importance of having different configuration on your local and your production environment. First of all, the local and the production environment is always different, from major configurations such as the database password to minor ones such as showing some extra login. Creating configuration files is one of the most boring tasks, but believe me, they will be really beneficial for the long run as you will have a well-structured project. And of course, for security reasons. I hope you don't have the same password locally with your production environment, do you? And lastly, clean code and clean Git repositories, as you don't need to hard code environmental configurations everywhere within your code anymore. Now let's see how we can change those environmental configurations. The good news is that Codeigniter is using a well-known technique for that. Codeigniter is using a .env file to get the environment configurations. .env is a simple and a very powerful tool as it is meant to have only environmental variables. Okay, no more waiting, we will now dive into some code and let's see an example. At your Codeigniter project, you will notice that there is a file with name env. You can copy this file and then rename it to .env with the dot at the beginning. If you are using Windows, you can simply rename it to .env dot and it will magically rename it to you to .env. Now open the file with your favorite editor. Usually the configurations that we are changing are the following. The local URL is different from the one that we have on the production. For example, a conversion that I'm using is replacing the www with local, so I will not forget the local URL name. For example, if www.grocerycrud.com is my production URL, my local URL would be local.grocerycrud.com, so I can easily remember it. As you can also see from my screen, I'm commenting out the variable app.baseURL and I'm adding my local URL path. Oh, and by the way, this is the way that we will add environment variables, by commenting out our desired configurations. The second most common variable that we change is our database credentials. There is not much to talk about database credentials, to be honest. Search for the word database and then uncomment the database.default credentials with yours, as you can also see at your screen. And of course, don't forget to uncomment the most important variable with name CIEnvironment. If you are at your local environment, you should have the CI_environment equals development, as you can also see at your screen. Once you have done that, you will notice two main differences at your website. First, you will notice the debug tool at the bottom right. The debug tool is giving you some useful information about the page, and this will also help you at the next tutorials as you can see some detailed information about the page. For example, at this page, I can see that I'm using the controller web pages and that my view path is the one that you can see at your screen. If you don't know what a controller and a view is, don't worry, as this will probably be my very next tutorial. So if you don't want to miss that, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also, an important note here about the debug tool. In case you can't see the debug bar and it is driving you crazy, don't worry, as you are not alone. You probably haven't configured base URL correctly. For example, I've noticed while I was trying to present you the base URL that I couldn't see the debug bar. Once I've changed it to the actual base URL of the project, the debug bar was there again. The second main difference that you will notice when you are in development mode is a more detailed error reporting. As a math nerd, I like to try dividing a number with zero that I know that so far it will return me an error. As you can also see at your screen, there is a detailed error reporting about the issue. However, if I change my environment into production, you will see that the error page is just a generic error page that doesn't give you any information about the error. So let's sum up the most important things that we've learned today. .env files are different in your local environment and in production environments. For example, in my local machine, the .env file looks like this, although in production environment, it looks like this. Number two, the .env file shouldn't be in your codebase as these are sensitive data. That simply means that you have to add it to the .gitignore file if this is not already there. In my personal experience, it is very important to start with the environment files first to make sure that we have everything we need before we start. That's it guys, I hope you did enjoy the video. I wanted to keep this video short so it can be useful and informative. Also, I am very excited as I've just released Grocery CRUD for Codeigniter 4. Thank you again for supporting this channel. Stay safe and speak to you guys to the next video. Bye.